Hello, Apple Valley High School Fab Lab students. It's Mr. Lee, and today what I'm going to show you is how to create a keychain with the laser engraver. The first thing that I'm going to do is look for an image, and the image that I want should be a black and white image. So I'm going to search for Captain America because I kind of like Captain America. So I'm going to look for a black and white silhouette. And I want to find a JPEG, so I'm going to put that in as well. And so when I look for that image, I'll get several. And on these, we're more interested in detail because the laser can do a whole lot of detail where some other types of images that we use on some of the other machines can't do detail as well. So I'm going to actually click on this one. And then I'm going to right click and save image as. And we're looking for JPEGs, and this one is a JPEG, so I'm gonna name it Captain America. One, because I already have a picture of his face. That's this one here, I named that Captain America. So I'm gonna call this Captain America One. And I save that to my desktop. Next, what I'm gonna do is check that Adobe Creative Cloud is launched and that I'm logged in with my account, and you should check that too. And so I am, because that's going to give us storage in the cloud. So I'm good with that. So now I'm going to go down, and I've actually put this on my taskbar. If you don't know where to look, you can search here by typing in Illustrator or going to the window and then going down to Adobe Illustrator. So there's a couple different ways to find the software. So I'm going to open that. It's a very big program, so it takes a while to load. And there's our start screen. So what I'm going to do is create a new document. And the first time that you ever do this, you're going to have to set up kind of some of the properties of it. So I'm going to make my workspace 10 inches by 10 inches. You can change that and make it anything you want. I'm going to select this as inches. I think it defaults as points. And then I'm going to go down to the advanced options, and you need to open that up because we need to select RGB for our color. The laser engraver will not recognize CMYK, so you have to have it as RGB. And then I set this, I think the default is 72 pixels per inch. We're going to set it at 300. And then I'm going to say create. And there's my 10 by 10 inch workspace. So now a nice key command is control key and the R key. That turns on rulers. And then control and the comma or quote key turns on the grid. That gives us kind of a reference. Here's another thing that I'm going to do because we're using Adobe Illustrator 2020. I'm going to go to Window and then Workspace and turn on Essentials Classic. So that's a layout that's a little bit different than what we had when we opened it up. And it also gives this stroke and then this user interface that aren't in the Essentials toolbar, but we need them for the laser engraver. So now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to create a rectangle. So I'm going to go to this tool, and you notice any of the tools that have a little drop-down arrow, that means they have more hidden features. So if you click on them and hold it, you'll get the other features. So I'm going to go to the rounded rectangle. And then I'm going to click. It'll give you a box that you can put in dimensions. I'm going to make my keychain 1 inch wide. So I'm going to change the width to 1. And the height I'm going to change to 2. So it's 1 inches wide by 2 inches tall. This corner radius I'm just going to leave. And I'm going to click OK. And there's my rectangle. I'm going to go up to the select tool because I want to unselect it so you can see some things. First thing is that the inside is white. That's called the fill. This black line is called the stroke. And right now the stroke is 1 point. Well, the laser won't do anything. It won't cut if it's 1 point. It's got to be smaller. So we're going to change that. And I'm going to take out the fill because I don't need it to be white. So I'm going to go here. If I select the fill and then go down to this box, this will take out the white fill when I have it selected. So I'm going to select that, and now you can see that we can see the grid behind it. So that means that the inside is clear. There's nothing there, which is good for the laser when it engraves. It won't get in any extra information. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to work on the stroke. So I'm going to click this box and bring that to the front. I'm going to double click on that box, and that'll give me the color picker. Now, when the laser sees pure red, it will engrave, or it will actually cut. So I'm going to go up to here, and pure red is FF and then four zeros. So that's something that I've actually memorized because I use it so often. And now I'm going to click OK. And I'm going to click off of this so you can see that the rectangle's now got a red path around it. And that stroke is red. Well, the laser needs two pieces of information, not just that you are want to cut it, but you also have to tell the thickness. So I'm going to go up to the stroke, and I'm going to type in 0.001 for the thickness. But I have to select that and then type it in, 0.001. And then I'm going to hit the tab key. And so now you see, you can barely see that line. And that's because it's only 1/1000th of a point thick. But when the laser sees that information, it's actually going to cut through it. So now what I need is a hole for my keychain. So I'm going to go back over to this rectangle tool and click and hold it and go down to the ellipse. And when I get the ellipse tool, I'll click. I'm going to make my hole about 0.2 inches wide. So 0.2 and then 0.2. And now my hole is 0.2 inches by 0.2 inches. I'm going to select the select tool, and then I can actually move this around and put it in different positions. I like my keychain hole to be in the middle, but you can certainly put it anywhere you want. Now I'm ready to put in my image. So I'm going to go to File and Place, find my image, which is on my desktop. There's Captain America 1. I'm going to select that and hit place. And you'll notice it's huge, which is fine because we're going to do some things with this image in a minute. We can resize it. The blue X means that it's just a placeholder. It's not really part of the file yet. So what I'm going to do is go up to where it says Image Trace. The down arrow gives us some different presets. So for doing other work, you're going to actually use these. But for today, we're going to just do the default. So I'm going to click Image Trace. And what it did now, you'll notice that it kind of changed some of the image a little bit, which is fine. I kind of like that effect. The second thing, but the X is still there. So I have to go back up to this where it was Image Trace and hit Expand. And now you'll notice that that X went away. So now this image is actually part of the file. I can clean some things up. I'm going to right click on this box and I'm going to isolate it. Now I can actually get rid of things. So I'm going to get rid of that white background because I just want Captain America. So I'm going to hit the delete key or the backspace key, and I got rid of that. I'm going to get rid of this area and then get rid of this. So now we just have the Captain America. Now you notice my, I double click out to get out of the isolation mode. There's my rectangle. You notice Captain America is pretty big. So I'm going to get Captain America to be smaller. I'm going to select it, hold the shift key, and I can shrink him down so that he'll fit into my rectangle. So kind of put him up in here. Looks like I need to shrink him down just a little bit more. And if you want to zoom in on an image or zoom in and make your screen bigger, if you hold the command or control key and the plus key, you can zoom in. So that's what I just did there. That looks pretty good. I think I'm going to use the arrow key and move it down a little bit, but I have it centered. And here's my keychain ready to roll. So now I can save it as a file. So I'm going to go to File, Save, and you can save to the cloud because we're on Creative Cloud. If you were working at home, you'd want to definitely do that. But I'm going to save it to the computer because I have a flash drive I can put it on. And I'm going to put my last name, Lee, first initial, C, and then the class period that I'm in. So cohort A, second hour. So I'm going to go 2A, and then this is my keychain. And I want you to save it that way so that you know and I know what file that's for. And once I'm done with that, I'm going to show you on the desktop that I saved it to the desktop. And here it is. That's ready to upload to Schoology for the assignment. And then what I'll do is I'll grab that file and then get it prepped on the machine to print. And that's all for today. That's how to make a keychain. See you next time.